sometimes growing up in Britain, you can have like an identity crisis. Being with these people that were like speaking my language, I felt like they understood me. But I always felt like, yeah, I felt accepted.
In robes of sequin and lace, holding steaming bowls of nourishment, of calabash and wine, with drum talk and talking drums, we walked out in all our finery, where our architects had constructed a theater of joy for the songs that called out our names, to which we answered with our feet, ÓWÀMBÈ, ÓWÀMBÈ, ÓWÀMBÈ.
When it comes to Nigerian party, there are four things that are very, very important. Number one, the dressing. It's seriously very, very important. You have the food, wow. You do party, you don't give them good food, they will talk really about your party. We have the music, which is very, very significant. And you must also have the dancing floor.
Our parents, when they wore their Western clothes, they didn't look so special. When they dress up for a party, their heritage comes out, their beauty comes out, they're enhanced. Three of us were christened in a Christian church, and then there was a huge hall party. My mum had maybe four or five outfit changes. All her friends had the same outfits. They wore this velvet damask with gold embroidery. My mum had platform shoes on. So this is Ankara. Which has got a gold print over it to make it extra special. And then this is damask, which is actually really hard to get hold of now. And this is what our mums would use as gele. And when you tie it, it stays in every shape or form that you pull it in. So it becomes three-dimensional when you wrap it around your head. And we also, the men would make their caps out of this as well.
I'm from the like minority part of Nigeria. In Ijaw hall parties, they don't do the typical geles that we see today. They really go dramatic with their geles. The actual outfits are just so unique and rich. We call it Indian. The wrappers are definitely the most beautiful things I've ever seen in my life.
When we put on something that's got a sparkle, got a shine, got a colour to it, it just is life affirming.
Music brings life to any party. Music is a vibe. Music makes your party rich.
We're not ready. Listen, let's go. Come on.
Especially when it comes to Nigerian music, you can't have any party without not having music in there.
The role that live band play in a party is like the party starters. They'll start playing around the time when people are getting their food. After that, bam, tempo goes up, everything goes up, everyone's gassed, everyone's got drink in the system, food in the system. Now it's time to really set this party up.
It gives me more pomp. because I can see that people are enjoying what I'm doing. And my brain is just thinking of more crafts just to destroy the whole place. The percussion is more or less the foundation. The talking drum is like it's like a house. Yeah, when you have a house and then you have a fence around the house. So the talking drum is the fence that surrounds the whole house. That's it.
Guys, my name is Adebisi. Can you play me Adebisi? Adebisi. Adebisi.
When they are playing the talking drum, they're speaking a language with the band, they're speaking a language with the song. It's like the perfect synergy, perfect harmony. It's like musical heaven.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
a lot of people don't know, but the live band artists like the Ologos, the Serafus, the Solex, they and many of their players would have derived from a white garment church. So when they are performing at hall parties, it will still have the church songs. It will still have the rhythms that they play at church.
A white garment church is, it's like a spiritual church. I don't wear shoes in our church, we wear white, and it's very heavily influenced with like a lot of African music. We speak Yoruba or whatever your native tongue is, we speak that in the church.
I always thank the person that created that thing. Spray money. Oh my God. Thank you, whoever you are. I pray for you. That's yummy.
The whole point of spraying money was almost blessing somebody. So you came to their wedding or their party and you're spraying them money. You know, we appreciate what it is that you've done. Let's say you've had a baby. Ah, God bless you that you've had a baby. This is amazing. We're giving you money like a gift.
Yeah, that's the best part of like, you know what? One of the best part.
It's actually the bestest of the best of the best. He's not even one of his number one best.
The live band singer, for example, will shout out your area. Like you're from in Nigeria, shout out your name, your family name. You get gassed, you'd be like, yeah. You go up, take $100 from the dollar man that's walking around in the party. You start spraying, they keep saying your name more. They keep saying your family, your friends. You get gassed, you get gassed.
And my mom will say, Iriawe. Then the woman will say, hey, it's beautiful.
A jump is a form of a party for a live band. So you don't get paid to be at that booking, but you go to this jump, and whatever money you make there through the dollars, which is sometimes you can make more money there than you made in your booking at a wedding, it's the money you take home.
Culture, traditions follow through a chain. I've always been intrigued to see how my generation, when unfortunately our parents go, if we're gonna still keep the buzz alive of hall parties. My mum is the person that will be shouting Iriawe everywhere because she will hold the mic. I don't know if I'll have that same confidence or that same ability or skills to do that. And that's something I fear the most.
Parties in London, they're still struggling to be like that of Nigeria. Very, very colourful, but unfortunately here, you know, it's too expensive. I think it's time for me to slow down parties. And my wife suggests that we go holiday once every year.
As our parents and that generation get older and they either go back to Nigeria or they're just not in the partying mind state anymore, it's a certain generation that are going to get washed out.
Baji is a Yoruba word. It means enjoyment, enjoy yourself with your money, turn up, have a good time. Well, some people have come to Baji and maybe they've just come from Nigeria and they've been here for like 10 years. And they come to Baji sometimes and they're like, oh my gosh, we went to school in Nigeria together. I haven't seen you for 10 years. Without the people, there is no Baji Sundays. They come to have a great time. They come to have fun. They come to celebrate.
So last year, we celebrated Nigerian independence with NS10V10. We did the celebration because it was celebrating black culture, but to the younger generation. no matter where you're from, like in Nigeria, live band music, cool party music, will bring people together.
Sometimes there's a disconnect between our older generation that have been doing the hall parties and doing the live bands to the younger generations. It was literally that gel.
I love being Nigerian. I don't think anybody understands how much I appreciate, and I love being Nigerian. I love being Yoruba. That's why you have Faji Sundays now.
If you haven't been to a hall party before, just sit back and enjoy. Actually, not sit back, get involved. Eat the food, dance to the music, look at how everyone's dressed, look at the expressiveness, take in the beauty of everyone that's there.
It's part of our culture. Party is Nigerian culture.
Our parents being able to pass it down to us, it means we can pass it down to our children, and you know, our history will not die.